Hi, this is Chuck Prophet, and you're listening to Live at Club Cafe, the next stage in music. They told me to say that.
Tonight on Live at Club Cafe, he claims his two biggest influences in life are a preacher and a pimp.
My family is kind of like the Osmonds in a way, because there's lots of talent. I guess I'm the only one in the family that's out playing the devil's music now, you know?
Plus, Chuck Prophet. His music's where folk, soul, rap, and rock all meet, and he's been taking it out to everyone who will listen.
It's hard to even determine what a good show is. You might think you're having a good show, and you're playing in front of five people in Fayetteville, Arkansas, and three of them are involved in a heated game of pinball.
Two great artists, one great night. Sit back, you're watching Live at Club Cafe, the next stage in music. I'm Mara McFalls, and we are at Club Cafe on Pittsburgh's South Side. Kicking off tonight's show is Paul Thorn. He's a good old Southern boy from Tupelo, Mississippi. He's always loved music, but since he's the son of a preacher man, he was never allowed to go to a show until he opened for Sting. Tonight it's time to discover the wild world of Paul Thorn, live at Club Cafe, the next stage in music.
I'm the most famous guy you've never heard of, you know? My girlfriend, she went out on me 151 times. At least she was honest enough to admit it when she wasn't too busy lying. But I came to a realization the last time she kicked my tail. I'd rather be a hammer than a nail. Well, you know, Tupelo is... The claim to fame is that's where Elvis Presley was born, you know, and he did pretty good. And I just grew up, aside from Elvis being, the big deal in Tupelo, there's not a whole lot else going on. And it's just factories, chair factories, a shopping mall, a Kentucky Fried Chicken, and a couple of joints, juke joints. That's about it. And it took me 12 years to get out of there. But praise the Lord, here I am.
But now my private part needs an emergency jump start. I'm gonna go to Viagra before it falls. Should I keep on going?
Yeah.
I have to ask that because right there my daddy shook his head and said, no, son.
Yeah, my dad is a Church of God of Prophecy minister. They call it holiness faith. It's where they shout and speak in tongues and people pass out in the aisles and all that kind of stuff. But when I was about 3 years old, my father was a traveling evangelist and he would take me with him on the road doing revivals. And every night before my daddy would preach, he would stand me up on top of the altar where everybody could see me and I would sing a song before he'd preach. I was kind of like the opening act for the preacher.
He said, I quit my job at a big church where the milk and money flowed to sell cherry bombs for Jesus in a tent beside the road. I ain't in it for the money, most cars pass on by. But I paid a rent on New Year's and the 4th of July. Here at the Holy Ghost, Big Bang Theory.
There was a pivotal moment in my life when my uncle, who lived in Los Angeles, California, relocated down to the South and when I was in my early teens. And he was a pimp. That's what he did for 10 years. And that's all he did was pimp women. And that's not an honorable profession, and I don't think it is. But he was my uncle who had been out into the broader world. And when I was a kid, I spent a lot of time with him.
And he was a guy that taught me how to box. He was my trainer when I boxed. And me and him started hanging out. And so the worldliness you hear in my music, it's because my mentors in life have been pimps and preachers, you know? And so I like to think I got a lot of good from both.
And usually when I sing this song, I play my kazoo, but I left my kazoo accidentally back at the hotel. So I'm gonna have to imitate a kazoo as I sing this song. She drives a new car, wears expensive blouses. She tells her mama she's cleaning houses. She goes out witnessing, doing the Lord's work all week. But on the weekend, she's making ends meet. Johnny, the Jehovah's Witness stripper, put a dollar in her G-string, and she'll deliver. If her daddy only knew, he'd probably kill her. Johnny, the Jehovah's Witness stripper.
More Paul Thorn in a minute. Coming up later on in the show is Chuck Prophet. He was born of the LA punk scene, but now he's gone solo, he's crossed genres, and we've got him here in Pittsburgh, live at Club Cafe, the next stage in music.
The show is not for me, it's for the people. And so, you know, I try to have fun. So that's why I stay away from singing too many things that's gonna make somebody, you know, go shoot themselves or something.
I have a good day every now and then. I count my blessings on one hand. I start believing the sun will shine again. I have a good day every now and then. Da, 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 da.
Y'all sing with me.
I have a good day every now and then. I count my blessings on one hand. I start believing the sun will shine again. I have a good day every now and then. I have a good day every now and then.
I was simultaneously, all at the same time, I was working in a chair factory, playing in a pizza restaurant at night, music, and I was a boxer, all at the same time. And what happened was, with my music, what really popped for me was, I was playing in this little pizza restaurant one night, and this guy came in who worked for Miles Copeland, who managed Sting and the Police, and he heard me singing. You know, I had to sing the regular, you know, redundant cover songs like Brown Eyed Girl and all that, which was no fun, but every other song, I'd sing one of my own songs. And the guy liked what I was singing, and they flew me out to Los Angeles on a weekend, because I had to go there on the weekend because it was, you know, I worked a job, you know. So they flew me out there, and I sat down with the people at A&M Records, and they offered me a record deal. And they gave me some money, and I was able to quit my day job. And because I was a minister's son, I was never allowed to go to concerts when I was growing up. We couldn't do like worldly things. So the first time I ever went to a concert in my entire life, I was opening for Sting.
I guess I had to see it one more time. This little trailer we shared in better times. Way out yonder, see those big old black clouds moving. I wish the wind could blow me back in time. Those were the days I had it made when you were temporarily forever mine.
And so really my record coming out was really just a cruel joke on me, really, you know? And so when I lost my record deal, me and my songwriting partner, Billy Maddox. We have our own studio. We started our own record company. We call it Perpetual Obscurity Records. And we just went out and started building our career in the term they use called the grassroots by going out and touring and doing shows and building an audience. And you know, without the multi-million dollar publicity of some of these people who are big stars, that's the only way you can succeed. You have to go out and do it for yourself. And I'm real happy because it's working, you know? I mean, I'm no, am I household name? No, but I've been able to pay my light bill every month, and I even take my wife to the Cracker Barrel about once a week, and still got some money left over, you know?
In a little white house on a blacktop road, and her sleep is where she died. She walked through a tunnel with a light at the end and swam across a river of life. God gave her a mansion on a hill in heaven and her wings that afternoon. The preacher said she's in a better place, but if you want to know the truth, she's an angel. Too soon.
The song Angels Too Soon, I put it together to, well, first of all, if you believe in an afterlife, if you believe truly there is something good over there, I tried to say in that song that for people that's lost their children, try and focus on that as much as you can. Is, yes, they're gone and you miss them, but they're in a better place. Because the last verse of the song says, it's so hard for us to understand why she was taken away. But if you could see her spread her wings, maybe then you wouldn't say she's an angel too soon. You know, and then there's no joy in the song, but that's about the most optimistic way you could look at it, is to visualize them, you know, running in a field of flowers or something, you know. Sounds corny, but, you know, that's the way I look at it.
Around the house there's an emptiness, but her room still looks the same. There's heartthrob posters on the wall and a Barbie makeup case. Today would have been her birthday, so her mama made her favorite cake. She wasn't there to blow out the candles, but Daddy lit them anyway. She's an angel too soon. Yeah, pretty flower that never bloomed. Somewhere on the other side of the moon, she's an angel too soon.
Hey, music is the reason I'm getting to do this. I mean, the reason I'm getting to go out and see the world is because of music. And it's like I said, I value everything, you know, from my church upbringing to all of it. It all had to happen. You know, my pimp boxing uncle had to move back. It all had to happen for this to happen. And I revel in all of it, man. It's good. As long as it keeps getting bigger instead of smaller, I'm gonna keep on doing it.
Paul Thorne's latest CD, Are You With Me, is in stores now. If you wanna find out more about him, you can check out our website at clubcafelive.com. And now it's time to catch the buzz. Hear three new CDs on sale now that are definitely worth picking up. Singer-songwriter Andrew Bird from the famously cheeky band of the 90s, the Squirrel Nut Zippers, comes out with his fifth solo release, The Mysterious Production of Eggs. You can instantly hear that he's moved away from the big band retro swing sounds of the Zippers, and he's finally found a comfort zone with a laid-back new sound. Plus, singer-songwriter Nancy Griffith, she keeps striding the line between country and folk with her new release, Hearts in Mind. A lot of the songs seem to be inspired by the war in Iraq. Also out this week is Irish rock band The Frames. They've been around for 15 years and they give us their latest CD, Burn the Maps. It's got a great rainy day introspective vibe. Coming up after the break is Chuck Prophet. You're watching live at Club Cafe, the next stage in music. Welcome back. Our next artist comes to us from San Francisco, where he's been weaving himself through the music scene from his early days with Green on Red to his current turn as a solo artist. He's got a wry sense of humor and a keen eye for picking out the strange characters. He's 7 records into his solo journey, and tonight we are proud to bring you Chuck Prophet, live at Club Cafe, the next stage in music.
Birds and bees and chimpanzees buzzing around my head, swinging from trees. She's a deep dish pine, a precious flower, wrapped like candy, primped and powdered, while the creeper creep and the willow weep. In the dead of night, I'm a counting sheep. All night long, I toss and turn. I wonder what it's gonna take to learn what makes the monkey dance.
And my sister had an acoustic guitar that she got when she was in CYO camp or something, and she learned to play John Denver songs, and she you know, lost interest in it, and it was just sort of around the house. But I don't think my parents certainly. I came from a very loving family in many respects, but my parents never said, "Oh, gee, you know, he's got musical talent. We have to nurture this." They just wanted me to stay out of jail, I think. You know, I don't know.
Chuck spent his early days in the LA punk scene, but in 1990 he shifted gears from his raucous years with Green on Red and went solo.
We sat there exposed to the wind and the thunder, chilled to the bone, huddled together. You kissed me goodbye, and I called God a liar. We snuck off like thieves with our backs to each other after the rain.
Chuck resisted the comforts of staying in the bustling LA music scene, and instead he moved north to San Francisco, where he instantly found home.
Los Angeles was more likely to invent somebody like Jim Morrison, you know. And I think San Francisco embraced the Grateful Dead and embraced Jerry Garcia, and he's a freak. I just love him, you know. I love everything that the Dead stand for in that way. And I don't really put myself next to any of that, but I do think that there's something. I think there's something in the air there. It's freaky.
LA lady lives in a home made entirely of styrofoam. Styrofoam window, styrofoam bed. She got a styrofoam body and a styrofoam head. Look out! Come on!
Stay tuned, because there's more Chuck Prophet coming up next, live at Club Cafe, the next stage in music.
I think when it comes to writing, I don't know, we used to say when I was in Green on Red, we borrowed this, I think, from Irving Berlin or somebody, some famous dude that would know a lot about these kinds of things. He was once asked what came first, melodies or the lyrics, and he said, generally, the advance. So, I always liked that line, so I borrowed it.
Better serve a coffee. Kept the biscuits warm. Never saw her even once out of a uniform. Katie had another dog she swore would never bite. Follow that girl everywhere, never left her sight. She said, baby, 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 crawl out of your shell. I wanna show you something if you promise not to tell. I said, ain't no mother gonna criticize me. I bow down and pray to every woman I see. All right.
Lucky for Chuck, traveling the world as a solo artist isn't a lonely road. His wife Stephanie's been playing keyboards and doing backup vocals out on tour with Chuck for the past 7 years.
She was going out with a friend of mine at the time, and we'd all been in bands that had fallen apart, and we were holding this kind of weekly poker night in the back of this neighborhood bar called the Albion in San Francisco in the Mission. And Steffi was just a great, great harmony singer. I don't know, it was just something about when we sang together, it was just, we just loved it, you know.
So baby, why you wanna keep it here? I've done so many things that I'm not proud of. Myself again. And if the moon's the only light left shining, I'll walk 1,000 miles. That's right. Oh, baby, just to see you smile. Baby, just to see you smile.
I know people think that, you know, show business relationships are very brittle and have short lifespans, but you know, we figured we're not really in show business, so you know, we don't really run those kind of risks. You know, I don't really think I'm going to be going out with Paris Hilton any day soon, so there's really no no threat of that.
Always a privilege and a great honor to be here at the Club Cafe. Hope to see you soon. Take care.
Chuck, Stephanie, and the rest of the guys are out on the road right now promoting their latest album, The Age of Miracles, on New West Records. If you want to find out more about Chuck, go to our website at clubcafelive.com. And now stay tuned, because coming up is a preview of next week's show.
Budweiser True Music presents A Moment in Time from the Club Cafe Archives.
Coming up next week on Live at Club Cafe. It's been 4 years since Amy Correa released her powerful debut CD, but both critics and fans agree it was well worth the wait. Plus, Hem takes the stage with songs from their sophomore effort, Eveningland. Thanks for joining us. I'm Mara McFalls. We'll see you next week.